Boys and girls, I'm going to start another class in physics. In today's class, I'm going to solve the creative question on chapter number 12. And the name of the chapter is here, Magnetic Effect of Current. And this is chapter number 12 in physics book. And in today's class, I'm going to solve third creative question on the basis of this chapter, okay? And in this class, I think this is my seventh lecture on the basis of this chapter, okay? From the stem, there's a transformer is given. In the transformer, in the primary point, there are 220 volts. It's the input voltage. Now the input current is here, 5 ampere. And input number of coil, our primary number of coil is 550 number of coil, a number of turns there, okay? And in the secondary part, there are NS, a number of coil in the secondary part is 125. The number of coil in the secondary part is here, 125. And there are some question below this stem, below this figure, that is question number A. What is called electric generator? Question number B is here. What are the difference between electric motor and generator? What are the difference between electric motor and generator? Now question number C, calculate voltage in the primary coil. Calculate voltage in the primary coil. And question number D, from the stem, mathematically show that, will it support conservation law of energy or not? From the stem, mathematically show that this stem will support conservation law of energy. Okay, in my previous lecture, we are going to solve or start our class to solve question number A. Question number A is here, what is called generator. You know, the another name of generator is dynamo. Generator dynamo is a very common term in the now city dwellers, okay? Generator is the machine which can convert chemical energy or mechanical energy into electric energy. This generator can produce electric energy, okay? So it's a machine, it's a converter, okay? So this converter can produce electrical energy, but it can consume maybe mechanical energy, maybe electric energy. So if I give the definition, then I can say that the electric device which can convert mechanical or chemical energy. Mechanical or chemical energy. Chemical energy in terms of electric energy. Electric energy is called electric generator. Electric generator. So electric generator is a device. Or if somebody says it's a machine, it's also correct. Electric device is a machine. The electric device or machine which can convert mechanical energy or chemical energy in terms of electric energy is called generator. In short, generator can produce electricity. Generator can generate electric energy. The another name of generator is here, dynamo. So dynamo is sometimes called generator. There are two types of generator. One is AC generator and another is DC generator. There are two types of generator. One is AC generator and another is here, DC generator. Now, question number B. Question number B is here, what are the difference between electric motor and generator? So in this case, we're going to show some difference in between them. So, before discussion about question number B, At first, we're going to set our created table. Okay, table. And I want to discuss about this question by tabulation format. In the first slot, this is I think motor, and the second segment, this is I think generator. So in first case, I can say that motor can convert electric energy into mechanical energy. So electric motor can convert electric energy into mechanical energy. Okay. So if I give you the definition of generator, like the definition of motor, then I can say that electric generator can convert chemical energy into electric energy, mechanical energy into electric energy. So electric generator can convert electric or chemical energy in terms of electric energy. Okay, so I can say that electric generator can convert mechanical or chemical energy. Chemical energy in terms of electric energy. So in the case of generator, I can say that electric generator can convert mechanical or chemical energy. I repeat, mechanical or chemical energy into electric energy. Mechanical or chemical energy into electric energy. Okay. So these are the definition of electric motor and generator. Now, example. The example of electric motor is electric fan, water pump, etc. is the electric motor and generator. The example of generator are AC and DC generator. Is that two types of generator here? Okay. So the example of generator is an example of generator is electric or mechanical generator. I repeat, generator is AC or DC generator. AC or DC generator. AC or DC generator is the two example of generator. Okay. So these are the two example of generator. Okay. For marks 2, I think these two difference is quite enough for your exam. Now, in question number C, you see, question number C is here, calculate voltage in the secondary coil. Voltage means what? Voltage means here, the electromotive force in the secondary coil, okay? You see, for the primary coil, electromotive force, total current, and number of coiling is given. And for the case of secondary coil, only here, number of coil is given. And from this information, you have to find out the electromotive force in the secondary coil. from this transformer you want to find out the electromotive force of the secondary coil. Okay, now I'm going to find out the value of electromotive force for the case of here secondary coil. Okay, so let's see how can I find out this, the electromotive force for the case of secondary coil. Okay, let's see here. Question number C, we know that the general formula of a transformer, that is EP divided by ES equal to NP divided by NS. I think this part is quite enough to solve question number C. You see here EP is given, NP is given, NS is given, and you want to find out the number of the produced electromotive force or induced electromotive force at the secondary coil of this transformer. Now if I write down the given information, so given that here EP will equal to here 220 volt, EP will equal to here 220 volt, NP equal to here 550 number of coil or number of turns, NS equal to here 125. Okay, and you want to find out the secondary electromotive force or produced secondary electromotive force. Okay, that is ES. So from this stem you want to find out the value of ES or secondary electromotive force here. Now I can say that here ES will equal to NS divided by NP into EP. ES will equal to NS divided by NP into ES. So NS equal to what? NS equal to, I think here, 125. NP equal to here 550 into NEP. It will equal to here 220 volt. It will equal to here 220 volt. Okay. Now the value of this electromotive force is, yes. Now the value of this electromotive force, it will equal to what? It will equal to here 50 volt. It will equal to here 50 volt. So the produced electromotive force in the secondary coil, the produced electromotive force in the secondary coil will equal to 50 volt. So here ES equal to here 50 volt. The number of voltage in the secondary coil will equal to what? It will equal to here 50 volt. Okay, now question number D. You see in the question number D, from the stem mathematically show that stem will support conservation law of energy. You have to show this, your given stem will support conservation law of energy. So what is called conservation law of energy? You know that conservation law of energy is indicating that the amount of energy which is lost in the primary coil and the amount of energy which is lost in the secondary coil. Okay, these two amount of energy will be equal. These two amount of energy will be equal. Okay, so I can say that the amount of energy in primary coil will equal to the amount of energy in secondary coil. Okay, these two part energy must be equal. Okay, so how can I show this? We're going to find out the value of energy here. So I'm going to solve question number D. Now, once again, question number D here. You see, the equation of electric work done or energy is, the equation of electric work done or energy is equal to P into T or VIT or V square divided by R into T or here I square R into T or here I square R into T. So this is the formula of electric work done. And electric work will equal to electric energy. I repeat, electric work will equal to here electric energy. So first one is P into T. What does it mean? The multiplication of power and time. The second one is here V into I into T. V is voltage. In this case, voltage is replaced by electromotive force. So, electromotive force into current into time. And the second one is V square by R into T and I square R into T. So, in next segment, we just going to choose in which formula or by which formula going to show that the primary part of energy will equal to the secondary part of energy, okay? Or the conceived energy for the case of primary part, that will equal to the conceived energy for the case of secondary part. Okay, at first P into T. I think this is not a suitable formula for this case, because for this case, electric power is not given. So if you want to use this formula P into T, at first you have to find out electric power and then you have to use this formula. So you should take two steps to solve this math. So I think this is a long way to solve this math. That's why I cannot use here P into T. Now, if somebody want to use here I square R into T, it is also not a suitable formula because there is no resistance is given. There is no resistance is given, okay? So since there is no resistance is given, it's also not a suitable formula. Then my next point, V square by R, so again R is not given. So how can it, also in which formula, when to find out electric work done, it should be VIT. But there's another obstacles here. To use any one formula of this on this part. And that is, if you want to use any one of this formula, you need to know about the secondary current. What? You need to know about the secondary current, a secondary current that is IS. Which one is not given in the stem? Which one is not given in the stem? Okay. That's why to find out the electric work done in next segment, I have to find out the electric current in the secondary coil. So, electric current in the case of secondary coil, how can I find out this? We know that EP divided by ES, it will equal to here IS divided by IP. You know, IS equal to electric current of secondary coil, IP equal to electric current of primary coil. My first mission is I want to find out electric current of the secondary coil. So, electric current of the secondary coil IS, it will equal to EP divided by ES into IP. Into what? IP. Now, EP. Here, EP equal to what? Here, EP equal to 220 volt. Here, ES equal to what? Here, ES equal to 50. And IP equal to 5. So, what's the value of this secondary current? I think the value of the secondary current is here 22 ohm. I think if you divide this, then you say that the value of here is, I think it is 22 ampere. Okay, so 22 ampere is the secondary current. Is the secondary current, okay? Now I can say that in the secondary part of the coil, the amount of current is here 22 ampere current is the secondary current. 22 ampere current is the secondary current, okay? So in the secondary part of the coil here, 22 ampere current goes through. So the next step, I need to solve the main step of this question. That is, we are going to find out work done at first for primary coil and then work done on energy for secondary coil. Now, energy for primary coil. Energy for primary coil. Primary coil. That is, energy or work done is same. So that's why WP will equal to VIT. V is replaced by electromotive force, I is replaced by current and time t. I is replaced by current and time t. So EP will equal to 220 volts, I2 will equal to 5 and time 2. It will give you the answer, that is 1100 time t joule. So in this case, I cannot use the value of time t. Why I cannot use the value of time t? Because in the stem, no time is given in the stem. Okay, that's why time t path is remaining at the answer path. Okay, so the amount of energy that is lost by the primary coil, which one is 1100 t joule, and here t is the time. Time, the duration in which this transformer runs for. The duration that which this transformer can run for. Okay, and that time is t. Now, energy for the case of secondary coil. Energy for secondary coil. Secondary coil. Okay, so that is WS is the energy for the case of your secondary coil. Okay, so energy for the case of secondary coil. Okay, it will equal to also VI than T. V is replaced by secondary electromotive force. I is replaced by here secondary current, and T equal to time. Now, S equal to what? S equal to here 50. What is the value of IS? Equal to 22 and time t. Will equal to here 1100 time t joule. From this calculation, from above calculation, you can say that energy in the primary part of the coil, I repeat, energy in the primary part of the coil is 1100 t joule. And energy in the secondary part of the coil is also 1100 t joule. So the primary part of coil, the used energy, it will equal to the secondary part of coil, the used energy are equal. What about time t? You see, this transformer has two parts. One is primary part and another is the secondary part. Okay. When this transformer runs for t time in the primary part, then obviously you can say that it also runs for the case of t time in the secondary part. So for the case of primary part, the running time of this transformer will equal to, for the case of secondary part, the running time is also equal. So their running time seems equal. I repeat, so their running time seems equal. That's why we can say that. Okay? Top one. That's we can say that here. Primary part, work done for the case of primary part will equal to work done for the case of here secondary part. So this transformer can support conservation law of energy. This transformer can support conservation law of energy. Now, boys and girls, I'm going to give you a homework. You're going to solve this homework at your home. Okay? Now, your homework. Your homework is another transformer just like this. Okay. Primary coil, secondary coil. Primary voltage EP will equal to 220 volt. Primary current will equal to here 15 ampere. Primary number of coil equal to 1000. And only in the secondary part, secondary number of coil equal to 250 number of coil in the secondary part. On the basis of this transformer, you are going to solve that particular questions. So the question was A, what is called electric generator? Question number B, what are the difference between electric motor and generator? Question number C, from the stem, Question number C, calculate the voltage in the secondary coil. Calculate the voltage in the secondary coil. And question number D, from the stem, mathematically show that stem will support conservation law energy. Stem will support conservation law energy. Boys and girls, all of you, thank you very much.